Nicola and Esther are back with me. It's quite an interview, that, wasn't it, Nicola? I mean,
yeah.
You know, it's patronising to say you don't often hear footballers talk that way, but you don't.
No, I mean, he really changed my mind on so many different things. I went into that interview thinking that it was right for Russian players to play or go in as independents, and he spoke so articulately and passionately.
I've argued that, actually, on
I have.
The show.
I've argued it on
my instinct was you shouldn't ban the individuals. But when you listen to what he said,
yeah,
it's quite a convincing argument.
Complete change of heart, because what are they putting on the line? I've argued, I've defended people and said, well, what if Russia, you know, causes harm to them or their families? And he would just turn around and say, well, what is he doing to my entire country? In order to be an ally, you have to be all in, or you're not.
I mean, think, Esther, you could imagine a scene at Wimbledon where there could be a Russian male tennis winner, OK? He talks about him a bit cryptically in that interview, but if he was to lift it and be presented with it by a member of the British royal family, that's a hell of a moment for the Russians to claim a victory, right?
I get it, but I still feel very uncomfortable with banning, you know, people from certain countries because of their nation's, you know, political stance on many things. And I also think we have
to... where do you stop, right?
Exactly, but we also have to remember that, you know, they are not their country, and you can't punish individuals for something that their countrymen have done.
But you also have to remember it's his country.
Yeah, but he said something really
remarkable. It's his friends who've been killed. It's his family who live in terror. And I can completely understand...
But they're Russian victims.
..why Zinchenko feels the way he does.
But they're Russian victims.
I don't necessarily agree with it all, but I understand why he feels that way.
I think that the idea that you can punish someone for... an individual for something that their country does is really wrong. I don't agree with that. I don't think it's going to move the needle. And I also think we have to remember that there are Russian people on the other side who are also victims of Putin's war. And I don't think you're going to get very far by trying to convince people that, you know, you should ban Russian or Belarusian.
There's been a bit mixed reaction on social media, as I would have expected, but I just thought he was so raw and kind of articulate and emotion charged. This felt real.
Yeah.
Right, this wasn't the normal PR controlled footballer interview. This was a guy bearing his soul about something that has been the most life-changing thing in his world, right?
Yeah, and I really think it helps for British viewers as well. We often get fatigued with stories like this.
As he said.
Yeah, a year on, people are going, well, you know, there's only so many images you can see and feel horrified by, but to see it through his eyes was really, really powerful.
I think one thing that he said that I found, you know, quite interesting was he said it's not political, like, you know, standing
to him it's war,
but the thing is,
but
war
is
political,
of course,
exactly,
of course.
That's why they're two sides,
but it doesn't feel
war.
Political if you're on the receiving end of the
exactly,
box, right? You just feel like my people have been killed.
Yeah, but he plays for, you know, one of the biggest clubs in the Premier League. He has millions of eyes on him every week. He is a very powerful tool to keep, you know, the attention on this war going. And I think, you know, I think he should be using that. I think it's
and
very
they're doing this big charity game here, Andrei Shevchenko, another Ukrainian football legend, at Chelsea August the 5th, is to raise money to rebuild one of the schools that have been demolished. 800 schools have been really badly damaged in Ukraine, 220 irreparably. Imagine the damage to the kids' education, everything.